So here we are. We're at the HARP Historic Air Restoration Hangar in Floyd, Bennett, Field, Brooklyn / Queens, New York. And I'm sitting in the navigator seat of a C-47/DC-3 SkyTrain. And this thing is like diagonal, sitting on the ground. Here's the hangar. The cockpit. It's been 5 years since I've been here. I decided to take my friend with me. I stated with some of the old models, the second door here can open up and you can fit two Willys Jeeps in here. And here is the door that used to open. See? Air National Guard. Here's a 1942 Dodge ambulance from World War II, brought to you by the United States Army, with the Red Cross on the side. There's a stretcher and everything in there. This guy, something happened to him. I don't know what happened, but he got hurt. Here's an A-4B Skyhawk. This is a General Electric J-31 engine, as stated here on the poster. This is a cutout, as seen on how an engine works. This is the outlet, here's your inlet. This is where the exhaust, I'm guessing, comes out of. A-4B Skyhawk. We got a pilot in here. I wonder how long this dude's been sitting in here, huh? Check it out. Supposedly this thing made over close to 300 tail landings on aircraft carriers, and it made two trips to Vietnam. Here's the commander, John F., Lieutenant Commander. There's the inlet, there's the remove before flight panel to protect the engine from any particles. I believe this is a mariner, actually. Here's a tug, an airport tailing tug. There's a PBY Catalina over there, along, I believe that's a Waco aircraft. No, this is an albatross. Close resemblance to a mariner. Grumman HUI-6 Albatross. Multi-use flying boat used by the United States Coast Guard. This looks like, I'd say, from the 50s, maybe. No, the 80s. It was retired by the Coast Guard in 83. Here's some historical photos of it. This is Floyd Bennett Field when the Coast Guard used it for being a naval air station. Here's the landing gear assembly. The belly assembly. Now, check this one out. This is actually, I don't even know what the heck this is. This thing has a freaking 50 caliber machine gun on it. I'm afraid if I walk in front of it, I'm gonna get shot. Ooh, this is a T-6 Texan, I think? No, it's actually a PT Cornell. Actually, hold on, maybe it is? No, it wasn't. PT-26. Oh, this is Negro Chapo's favorite plane. Oh my god, this song. You got your analog gauges and everything in there. seems like they have a project here they're working on. Here's engine assemblies. Like Coleman Series 360 of a four-cylinder engine. Fuel-injected turbochargers included. There's a Curtis OX5. Wow, look at those. Look at the pistons and the injection chamber. ...1400 RPM. And this one... I'm believing these are... Heat... What is that? Heat releasing fins. There's a radial engine. Pa-pa-pa-pa-pa. It'd be like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, something like that. You can look up on YouTube on how a radial engine works. On YouTube. Rotary engine. Let's stay here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Nice series. Ooh, a Pratt & Whitney. Still making engines for the United States military to this day. Pratt & Whitney R2800. Here's another cylindrical engine. HARP stickers. Charles Lindbergh. Sikorsky R4, one of the first models of the Sikorsky Helicopter Company. Here's the restrooms. Oh, there's a male bathroom. Let's check out what's in the male bathroom, huh? Look at that. Door near aircraft. Anything over here? Nope. The Winnie Mae of Oklahoma. This one's built by Lockheed Martin. Here is the flying boat assembly for the PBY Catalina. There's a skeleton of her wing frame. The Forgotten Eagle. Lockheed Vega, Winnie Mae. Here's her cylindrical engine. Two-bladed rotor. Propeller, not rotor. Rotors for helicopter terminology. Oh, check this out. There's three heads on this air compressor. Look at that. Ingersoll Rand Air Compressor Company. Here's her model and serial number. 3,030. The T-30 air compressor. Emergency manual release handle. Wow. Pull and lock and catch. This is, I would suggest, that opens the hangar doors at the time of when this hangar was still in use. There's the old offices up there, barracks and everything. Well, if you want to be an old school air pilot, go here. I guess this is where they're working on restoration for the wings. Consolidated PBY 5A Catalina Patrol Bomber, or flying boat. Some models of the PBYs, as you see here, they would have a 50 caliber over here in the front. Not 50 caliber, maybe a 30 caliber Browning M1919. Some stickers. Seems like they're still in the process of restoring this PBY. Ooh. It seems that. that we can enter the interior of this PBY Catalina. Wow.
Look at this.
This would be the back, I guarantee. Yep. You can smell the lead paint on this baby too. Ooh. Here there'd be the two bubbles where they would put the guns. Imagine walking in this thing while you're in a freaking firefight. Wow. Look at this. This is probably where the navigator used to sit. Eh, Call of Duty World at War remembrances. Yeah, this is where the navigator would sit. Look at this old little lamp. Wow. I wonder if it works. Here's the cockpit of the PBY. This baby. Wow. Call of Duty. Look at that. Hitting through the thing. Black cat. It's a fire extinguisher. We used to rescue people with this. I'm surprised this thing's able to hold 9 feet. Is her wing frame, airframe and everything. Some variants that stated before they used to have the bubbles for the side gunners doing their rescue operations. Seems there used to be a logo on the side up there. Here's the albatross again. I'm guessing this was like a training plane or something. This looks like a Piper Cub actually.
EAA, wow.
Experimental Aircraft Association. This looks like a, well, of course it's a biplane. Maybe a Challenger? I don't know. This cafeteria area. Here's the, a wall commandering for the HARP. Historic Air Restoration Project of Hangar B, Floyd, Bennett Field, New York. Damn, that lead paint was a real big smell. This looks like a C-1. Or C... Yeah, this looks like a C-1. This looks like, I can't actually think of what this was supposed to. Here's the engine, the exterior, and you have the chamber. Look at this engine. This is a radial engine. Look at all these hoses and everything. Wow. Imagine working on all of this. Wow. To think what mankind can do, my friends. This looks like, this is definitely a T-6 right here. This has to be a T-6 Texan. United States Navy. It's not in the training colors though. Then again, here's the yellow paint. Here's a cargo plane over here. Yeah, let's look at the poster and see what type of aircraft it is. Just along with you guys, I may not know much, but I'm still learning a lot myself. This is a Beechcraft. Oh, here's official documentation on it too. A Beechcraft JRB Expeditor or something like that. Light transport. This is a training aircraft for transport. 1955, look at that. I wonder if it's the same tail number, look at that. Let's try to make it out, shall we? Here's a New York police aircraft. Let's see. This is a goose, Grumman goose. You can actually fly this as a beginner plane in Microsoft Flight Simulator X. JR5 Goose Light Transport. From what I know, this was actually originally in Coast Guard colors, and this was made during a party back in like the 2000s or something. That's when they repainted it as a police aircraft. No, this is Marine paint scheme. Actually, it's funny. It has Coast Guard colors. City of New York. What do we have over here? United States Army. I wonder what type of missile this is. Has to be a controlled missile. The Seabees, look at that. Old logo, Seabees. Here's an HH-3. Pelican. Coast Guard. This looks like a predecessor to the SHC King. Here's the interior. Seems like all the folding seats on the side were taken out. Here's her main rotor being held down by an arresting cable. One of her rotors seems like it was removed. Four bladed on both sides. Yeah, this guy's wearing a Coast Guard flight suit. Check that out, huh? Here's the documentation. Power plant, two 1,400 horsepower General Electric T-58 General Electric 10 turboshafts. Maximum speed 162 miles an hour. Climb rate 220. From what I know, FPS means frames per second. So if you know the other terminology for SPS, I'm still learning aircraft terminology. So if you can, please leave it down in the comments. Range 625 miles. Service ceiling 12,000 feet. That's the top before. I'm guessing that's the top before she stalls out. Usual gross 7,963 pounds. Max takeoff is 22,000 pounds. Rotor diameter length 62 feet, 57 feet, 3 inches. Wow. So this is some freaking helicopter for an oldie. There's another missile with its nose cone. Those rotors right there look like there's a missile. If you didn't see it before, I adjusted it. Those rotors look like it was part of a Russian aircraft, maybe a Tupolev. You never know. Seems like they're doing some wing work here. Airframe work. Here's more of the structure of the hangar. Here's the old roof and everything. This looks like that T-6 we saw earlier. This looks like one of her wings. They're probably doing work on it. This looks like wow, look at that old dial. Youngstown, Ohio. Automatic sprinkler cup. Oh, this is the sprinkler system. Look how old this technology is. This is amazing. If you think of the 1930s and the Industrial Revolution, circuit breaker boxes. Look at this. Some of the old rooms of the barracks and everything. United States Army Air Force / United States Navy Air Force. Insignia, United States Navy insignia. Some newspapers I guess they were using on the workbench here. It's amazing to see technology like this and infrastructure looking this way. Look how old this door is, damn. There has to be asbestos in here or something. carcass. This is where they keep, this is their workshop. There's the water if you can see it. I don't know this aircraft. And when we get up to the postal, we'll check her out. There's some tire tracks. Probably they were using the tug or something. Her engine is left open for everyone available to see. This is a Lockheed SP-2E. Yes, and I would say Neptune. Yep, it's a Neptune. This must be an original poster. I remember 5 years ago before Sandy happened, this poster was not like this. Yeah, this is an old poster. It's good material too. I'm surprised it fell apart. Here's her dimensions. Specifications. The builder is Lockheed Aircraft Corporation, Burbank, California. She weighs, when empty, 47,456 pounds. When she's full at max, she's 75,500 pounds. Dimensions. Her wingspan is 103 feet. Her length is 91 feet. Her height is 29 feet. Power plant. Two R.3350-32 watt radio engines. I'm guessing W means watt. 3,500 horsepower for those radio engines. And her turbojet engines. Oh, she has turbo. Oh. Guessing that's what that was when we saw on the rack before. Two J34 Western, the WE34 turbojet engines, 3,400 horsepower. Her performance, max speed is 345 miles an hour. Her max range is 2,200 miles an hour. Her crew is 9 to 3. And here's another photo of her.
I don't want to be stuck there.
You left the cup and the McDonald's on the table over there.
Yeah.
Make sure you clean it up. Don't
okay, we will.
It there, okay.
Okay, I'm listening. That means I gotta customize my video later. Damn it. Lockheed SP-2 Neptune anti-submarine patrol bomber. Oh, look at that. I'm learning more every, just like you guys. Here's her documentation information again. This looks like an olive paint scheme opposed to this paint scheme. I'm sorry these people are loud. I really apologize about it. Rude people. They see me on recording and they're loud as hell. Oh, look, a classic AIM-9 Sidewinder air-to-air missile. Hey, don't these bombs remind you of something? They had a thing that would spin and... boom. Her tail gear is up. Here's one of the turbojet engines from the Neptune. Here's some nice information. This aircraft was on the USS Intrepid. Let's see. Some old print on there. Here's the American flag in the background of this T-6. I didn't find a name of this aircraft, I don't believe. There's her full print on the left engine. The POW missing in action flag up there. Old runway floor. Looks like a support used to be here. Here's an old sign, check it out. Burma, Tunisia, Rome, Berlin, Paris, Floyd Bennett Field, Peking. Saigon, London, Tokyo, Guam, New Guinea, No smoking. Don't smoke around an engine, folks. So that they were towing her before with the tug. Back to the classic A4 Skyhawk and her Navy Swiss Marines paint scheme. Y831, I'm guessing that's a squadron number. Squad that she was in, or battalion. Reason why I came back over to the A4 because she's one of my favorite aircraft of the Vietnam War. Two times to Vietnam, imagine that. Here's one of her machine guns. Here's that barrel, and hits the inside of her barrel. I mean, probably can't see them because it's dark. So, probably a 50 cal, 30 cal maybe. Remove a full flight tag. Checking. Think about it, it's all links and everything for the landing gear to come up. Here's her air brakes. Air brake flaps. More air brake flaps. Arresting gear. This is the tail arrestor hook for when she lands on an aircraft carrier. USS John F. Kennedy. If you want to know where the John F. Kennedy is today of her existence, she is in the Philadelphia Navy Yard, pending probably scrap or something, but she's probably too expensive to scrap, therefore they have not touched her since they moved her there and taken her out of commission. VMA 131. I like the paint scheme on this A4. Lieutenant Colonel, United States Marine Corps. More removed before flight tags. Here's her tug wheel. This looks like a model of the Wright Brothers Wright Flyer. This is where the pioneering of aviation began. Yep, this is a remodel of the 1903 Wright Brothers Wright Flyer. It looks like there's another model over there. Wing fabric. Wow, this stuff is thin. Imagine flying thing with just paper and wood. And a fan belt engine. Sorry about all the little kids and people running around. It's an open day. Concluding it's Saturday, 12:11 p.m. Sorry about the camera unfocusing and everything. Here's the Albatross again. Hope you enjoy the music in the background. It's the best you're gonna get. There's the PT-26 again. Back into the PBY. Look at all the lead paint. Just to double check and everything. There's some words on the side of her. She didn't have her wingtips done yet, it seems. They're still fixing her wingtips. I wonder if they use a crane in here. Maggie just sitting in this thing. Just a lot of propellers while you're flying over the Pacific Ocean. I love the smell of old metal. Hey, grips, feet grips. Yeah, just like in Call of Duty, folks. There's your belly, your tail belly gunner. Then you have your nose gunners up there in the turret. And you have your bubbles here, just like in Call of Doo Doo. at this old ladder.
This thing's old as a motherfucker, man.
There's a tail once again. I love my PBY. I'm even wearing a shirt today about the PBY. There's ventilation ducts. Not much aircraft in the museum fly as from what I know, but it's a nice little trip. If you live in New York or if you come to New York, you can take the Q35 bus to the Ryan Aviator Recreational Station. You can get off and call a cab, or if you bike ride, you can bike ride from the bus stop over here. It's a nice little bike ride. I bike rode here before. Let's take a trip outside. The sun feels nice. You can feel the heat from the sun. Yeah, spring is coming, folks. It looks like there's two more engines over there. It's the sanitation training area. NYPD and the Marine Corps is on the other side. Pothole window. Hangar doors. Here's the rail tracks for the hangar doors. PBY. Do not have more than one hangar door open at one time. Unless authorized by hangar. I just can't make what that means. Probably officer. Unless you're authorized by a hangar officer, you cannot open more than one hangar door at a time. Coast Guard. Seems like there's some things here. Oh, broken ladders, oof. Don't ever want to work on a broken ladder. Here's some more pictures. The Memphis Belle. United States